Welcome to the Saul's Newsstand News Review for June 26, 2020. Fox Business reports, White House wins ruling on healthcare price disclosure. In the past 2 weeks, the White House has captured one healthcare ruling and lost another. The Trump administration put one in the win column with a court ruling Tuesday, upholding its plan to require insurers and hospitals to disclose the actual prices for common tests and procedures in a bid to promote competition and push down costs. President Trump suffered a major legal setback last week when a federal appeals court ruled that his administration lacks the legal authority to force drug companies to disclose prices in their TV ads. That had been a part of Trump's overall plan to reduce prescription drug prices that he has been pushing as far back as 2018. Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar called the recent decision in federal court in Washington, D.C., quote, a resounding victory for President Trump's efforts to open up the convoluted world of healthcare pricing so patients and families can make better informed decisions about their care. But the American Hospital Association, which sued to block the Trump administration regulation and was on the losing side, announced it would appeal. An article from CBS News states, crowds tear down statues, apparently attack Wisconsin state senator. Crowds outside the Wisconsin state capitol tore down two statues and allegedly attacked a state senator on Tuesday. Democratic State Senator Tim Carpenter said he was assaulted in Madison after taking a photo of protesters. Carpenter sent video of the incident to CBS News and also posted it on Twitter. Carpenter told the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, quote, I don't know what happened. All I did was stop and take a picture, and the next thing I'm getting 5-6 punches and kicked in the head. Earlier, statues of Wisconsin's motto, Forward, and of Colonel Hans Christian Haig were dragged away from the State House. The statue of Haig, an anti-slavery activist who fought and died for the Union during the U.S. Civil War, was decapitated and thrown into Madison Lake by protesters, the newspaper said. State Assembly Speaker Robin Voss took to Twitter late Tuesday night, calling the tearing down of the statue, quote, absolutely despicable. The protests unfolded after the arrest of a black man who was at a restaurant with a megaphone and a baseball bat. And finally, the Washington Free Beacon reports, Pelosi, I won't apologize for comparing GOP police reform bill to the murder of George Floyd. Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi on Wednesday doubled down on comparisons she made between the Republicans' proposed legislation reforming police practices and the murder of George Floyd. She told MSNBC she, quote, absolutely would not apologize for the comparison made Tuesday and said Senator Tim Scott's legislation would, quote, make no difference. Pelosi said, quote, absolutely, positively not, when asked if she would apologize to Republicans for the comparison. She went on to say, quote, I think you, frankly, in the press, have given them far too much credit for a bill that does nothing. They're saying, well, you have your bill, they have theirs. Yeah, our bill does something, theirs does nothing. Pelosi told CBS News on Tuesday that she saw Scott's proposed legislation as, quote, trying to get away with murder, actually the murder of George Floyd. Scott's bill, the Justice Act, proposes limiting police use of chokeholds and recommends new training and de-escalation measures, among other things. Less than 2 hours after Pelosi's appearance on MSNBC, Democrats blocked Scott's legislation from proceeding in the Senate. House Democrats are expected to pass their own legislation imposing stricter reforms on police departments. And that concludes your Saul's Newsstand News Review for June 26, 2020. For more political news faster, visit saulsnews.com.